you welcome yourself to this space, allowing yourself to fully let go, giving yourself permission, inviting your body to release. Sensing the sounds in the room and the sounds outside. As if you could draw your awareness to the sound closest to you, your breath, and the softness, allowing the softness to caress you. Noticing where it turns and how the circle can be smoothed out even more. And if you need to release any more tension, if you're sensing you're still holding around the shoulders or the hips, your belly, having another sigh or breathing deeper, just actively, intentionally breathing out the tension. Welcoming yourself with fullness, with full, immersive wholeness. Noticing the silence and the space. As we rest on the ground, sensing your body letting go and the heaviness of the back body, the back of the arms, the shoulders, back and the lower back, the legs, and the back of the head. As if you could imagine yourself leaving an imprint underneath you on the mat, on the floor, how this would look, how your body is placed now. And perhaps looking from underneath how your body would look from below. Moving your awareness to above your body and your skin, pressing against your clothes as you breathe, the movement of your chest and lungs, the fabric and the blanket on the top of your body, and how your body looks from above, as if you could see yourself from above looking down, taking deep breaths, deep peace. I wonder if you can move this to the side of you and how you would look from the side. and then the other side. I wonder if you can draw your eyes within, and as if you could sense and see and feel all the way through the body, all the way down through your organs, to the toes and the fingertips. How this is for you. Exploring your body as it settles and rests, giving yourself permission to fully let go and surrender. And allowing the breath to fill your heart, filling your lungs, your chest and your heart. So if you could see your heart and your lungs inflating with the breath and releasing, cleansing with an exhale. So if you could see around your heart, around the back of your heart, breathing there for healing. Around the sides and the front of your heart. And how this feels, the different areas of your energetic heart, just with your awareness, with your intuition. Allowing your heart to possibly turn around. Can this be? And how this will be for you? Turning your heart around. Allowing your heart to cleanse and reset, to rebalance, re-energize. And the spiral again, moving around with your breath. Sensing with each inhale the lungs inflating around the heart inflating. And with each exhale, a softening. And actively using your breath to cleanse. Hearing the sound of your breath and the pause between the inhale and the exhale. The pause of the exhale and the inhale. Noticing what happens in this pause and this space. And the silence. Inviting this space into your heart and into your mind as well. So the thoughts that pass by, are just welcomed, and then they can float by like clouds in the sky. And the feelings in your heart also are welcomed, and then allowing them to pass by. Sensing the heart, and the heart filling up and then emptying as well, in your own way. How the heart can be full, and how this feels, and how it can be empty, peaceful, with space for new, fresh energy. Sensing the rest, and then the recharge. As if you could breathe into your heart. Now listen into your heart. Listening as if your heart had an ear, a mouth and a nose, maybe eyes as well. And how this would be for you, listening to your heart, listening to the breath, the space, the fullness and the emptiness. Listening like waves of the ocean moving through. Listening to your own soul, your own heart song, your sankalpa, your heart's prayer, your heart's desire that can naturally arise. Maybe your sankalpa, your heart's prayer is an affirmation. Maybe a word in the present tense, a positive statement that you'd like to bring to your life or that you have already in your life. Perhaps your sankalpa is a prayer, a devotion, a dedication. Breathing this out and through and in, and sensing how your heart's prayer and your heart's energy can maybe lift above you like the spiral, and this can swirl, and as if it was being sent out above you, above this room, above this building, above York and above the world. Your heart's prayer moving all around the world, like waves of the ocean, the vastness of space. Your heart's prayer has no limit, has no form, so it can be boundless. Within your heart's mouth, nose, ears, and eyes, sensing a smile naturally rising and blossoming, a smile of gratitude for all of your teachings, all of your own uniqueness. Bad and the good. And this smile possibly moving through you, possibly moving down through all of the organs, down to your legs and feet, all the way up through your heart center, up to your head, mind. Blessing the whole of your body, welcoming your own body with gratitude. Saying thank you to your heart, thank you to your body. As we start the rotation of consciousness, on each part that's named, you may like to bless each part, thank each part. You may like to imagine a star on each part of the body, to form a constellation of stars. Or just simply shining the light of conscious awareness on each part. We'll start with our right hand thumb, sensing and feeling your right hand thumb, shining this light there and blessing. Next, moving to your right index finger, middle finger, ring finger, little finger, all of the fingers and thumb together, shining in light. Back of hand, palm of hand, the right wrist, forearm, elbow, upper arm, shoulder. Moving to the right side of your rib cage and across each rib, shining this light. Down through the right side of the body, across the right hip. Moving down the right leg to the thigh, knee, lower leg, ankle, heel, sole of foot, instep, right big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, little toe, and all the toes glowing together, shining in light, moving this awareness all the way back up through the right leg, the right side of body, back through the right arm to the hand and the thumb, Now moving to the left hand thumb, sensing, feeling the left hand thumb. Moving to index finger, middle finger, ring finger, little finger, all of the fingers and the thumb together, blessed and shining in this light. Back of left hand, palm of left hand, wrist, forearm, elbow, upper arm, left shoulder, left side of ribs, and each rib in turn being lighted up. The left side of body, left hip, down the left leg, the upper leg and thigh, knee, lower leg, ankle, heel, sole of foot, instep, left big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, little toe. All of the toes together, glowing in light. And this glowing radiance inside the whole of the left leg, moving up the left side of the body, down the left arm, to the fingertips and the left thumb again. Resting this awareness now into your heart and your heart center once more. This light shining there and beaming out. With each breath, the light from your heart growing. And this glow filtering out throughout the torso, moving this light down through all of the organs, swirling around, down to the pelvis, sensing the left side of the pelvis being lit up and blessed, the right side of the pelvis being lit up and blessed, the middle of the pelvis, sensing your tailbone, the base of your spine, as if you could travel up each vertebra, shining this light up and through the spaces, up to the base of the head and the skull, the top of the spine where it meets the skull, sensing this light lighting up the back of the skull and the head, top of the skull, crown of the head, moving your awareness to your forehead and relaxing here, sensing the left temple and the right temple and the space in between. Sensing your left eyebrow, your right eyebrow, your left eye, around the eyeball and deep into the eye socket. Sensing even your left eyelids and eyelashes, and each eyelash being lit up like a tiny filament of light. How this feels for you. Moving to the right eye and the right eyeball. the right eye socket, eyelids, and eyelashes once more. And the softness perceived here across the eyelashes, like little fluttering butterflies. Sensing your nostrils and the breathing that we did before, with the pranayama and aloma viloma. Breathing now out through the left nostril and back in through the left nostril. And moving to the right in your own time. And sensing both nostrils and the tip of the nose. Sensing the left cheekbone, shining this light across the cheekbone to the left ear, and the spiral of the left ear down to the inner ear canal inside. As if you could travel through the head to the right ear canal, shining this light out of the right ear, around the spiral of the ear architecture, and across the right cheekbone. Resting this light on the upper lip and the place between the upper lip and the nose. Light traveling to the lower lip, across the lower jaw. It's light moving within the mouth, inside the mouth, noticing the moisture, the softness of the mouth, the teeth, as if each teeth within the mouth could be blessed and lit up. The tongue in your mouth, the tip of the tongue, and the base of the tongue leading down to the throat. Sensing across the throat again, down to the left collarbone. This light traveling across the left collarbone and the right collarbone. Blessing this space, and the space in between the collarbones. The left breastplate, and the right breastplate. The left lung, and the right lung. And the heart center once more, resting within your heart center. Sensing the breath moving through, maybe taking deep breaths if this feels natural for you. Maybe a sigh once more. Now sensing the whole of the right arm and hand be lit up. All of the points lighting up the whole of the right arm and hand. Then moving to the left arm and hand as if you could only sense these points, and these points are lit up, the left arm and hand, bright and shining. And sensing both arms together and hands together, both arms and hands, how this feels for you. And moving to the right leg and the right foot and lighting up again. All the way through and within, this light beaming and shining, down the whole of the right leg and foot. And moving across to the left leg and foot, sensing the difference here, and the light traveling all the way through the left leg and foot. And then sensing both legs together, how both legs feel in this present moment, right now, both together, as if both legs were lit up and shining. Now please bring your awareness to the whole of the left side of your body. The left side of your face, arm, hand, body, leg and foot, the whole of the left side of yourself. Sensing this and lighting this up in your own conscious awareness. And then traveling across to the right side, the whole of the right side of your face, arm and hand, body, leg and foot, all being lit up within and all the way through the right side of the body, shining in light. Now sensing the whole of the body, all of the body together, from the feet all the way up throughout, the expanse of the body, the expanse of the space, interior and exterior, the breath and the whole of the body breathing together. Taking five deep breaths in this space, the space of your body, the space of your heart and your soul, mind, all within, all the movements and the space. And perhaps this stillness, great stillness, perhaps this stillness can be expanded even more. Now I wonder if you can light up parts of the body randomly, moving around the body quickly, lighting one part and then the other, opposite or wherever you feel. Actively focusing your mind on these points of the body to light up randomly, like they're flashing for a moment, a brief second in time. And how this feels for you, how this is unique for you. And then resting with the whole of the body again, just glowing softly in radiance, illuminated from within and glowing out with this peace and love, healing and nourishment. Sensing around your heart once more, moving around your heart with healing and cleansing. with thanks and gratitude for the whole of yourself, all of yourself, every part. I wonder if you can bring your awareness to the space of your third eye again, Ajna Chakra, of the mind's eye, of your intuition, your inner teacher. Looking within once more, seeing the beauty of yourself, the beauty of all aspects, the beauty of the imperfections, the beauty of your realness. And the beauty of you being perfect just as you are, to grow and to be your own teacher and allow others as well to be teachers for you. And seeing around as if you could see around in your life people or relationships, maybe even circumstances that's happened today. And how this restfulness of your body and the stillness can bring more insight, more resolution for you. Allowing yourself to be with peace and acceptance. And this once again, moving all the way through you like a wave of the ocean, cleansing. This ocean wave now bringing you to your mind's eye once more and a space called Chittakesh, the mind's lens, which is like a void of darkness or patterns of light, or a space where we can visualize or sense these visualizations. And with Yoga Nidra, we feel into the senses of our body. Next, please imagine hot baked warm bread that's just come out of the oven. And how this smells, the smell of this warm bread. Maybe the texture of this bread, the softness. And the shape of the bread. How this bread would taste in your mouth. And even how the bread would sound as you tear a peace off. Changing this to a lemon that's ripe and juicy and zesty, and how this is for you, the smell of a lemon, the shape, the texture, and the taste of the lemon. As if you were tasting the lemon right now on your tongue. What this brings to your mouth and your senses and your mind. Next, changing this to a ice lolly. A cold, frozen ice lolly. And what colour, what flavour this would be for you. The sensation of coolness on your tongue. The coldness on your tongue, tingling. And maybe this is felt within the mouth with more moisture. Next, imagine the sun above you and the sun in a hot summer's day. And the sun basking down onto you as you absorb the sunlight, the sun rays into each pore and the whole of your skin is illuminated by the sunshine. And the heat of the sun is getting hotter. And with your awareness, trying to raise your body temperature and the heat within you, each breath getting hotter and hotter, the sun stronger above you. Each breath, your body is feeling the heat, until you feel as hot as you possibly can be. And then cooling down to your natural body temperature. Just allowing the breath to move. And each breath cooling back down to normal. And as we observe all these different sensations, sensing how they make you feel and the reactions within you. Next we'll move to speed and imagining yourself moving faster from walking to running. How this would be, and then from running to running as fast as you possibly imagine yourself to run. Across the earth, and then maybe the speed increases, so you lift off the earth, and you become even faster still, traveling through space or across the world. Traveling perhaps up to the speed of light, so, so fast, faster and faster and faster. And then slowing back down again, perhaps moving through all the different speeds back down to walking. And observing the effect this has on your mind and your body. Next, moving slowly, imagining yourself moving in a space as slowly as you possibly could be. So your body is still moving as if it was through a thick substance or tiny, tiny, minuscule movements. How this would be for you. Now you could move slowly in one particular area of your life or of a favorite place. Observing this effect it has on yourself once more. Then letting this go. Breathing through the body again. Sensing the whole of the body, deep breaths. Resting in your heart space. So I play these sounds next. The sounds are healing sounds that plunge down to quantum level within you, your cellular level. The sound is proven to heal, to restore, reset. And some sounds you'll like, some sounds you may not like. Some sounds will be loud, some are quiet. Again, observing the effect this has on you. Breathing through. Perhaps you can beam out love or explore any emotions that come up fully. Give yourself this time to explore the sounds in your body together.
Thank you. and read a passage by Steve Araboli, Dare to Be. When a new day begins, dare to smile gratefully. When there is darkness, dare to be the first to shine a light. When there is injustice, dare to be the first to condemn it. When something seems difficult, dare to do it anyway. When life seems to beat you down, dare to fight back. When there seems to be no hope, dare to find some. When you're feeling tired, dare to keep going. When times are tough, dare to be tougher. When love hurts you, dare to love again. When someone is hurting, dare to help and heal them. When another is lost, dare to help them find the way. When a friend falls, dare to be the first to extend a hand. When you cross paths with another, dare to make them smile. When you feel great, dare to help someone else feel great too. When the day has ended, dare to feel as you've done your best. Dare to be the best you can. Dare to be. Taking deep breaths. Once again, if you feel into your sankalpa, your heart's desire, your affirmation, if you feel this is right for you, sending this out to the world with love and peace, thanks and gratitude. Listening to the sound of your breath once more. The sounds furthest away. Listening to the space and the silence and the space within. Sealing this in the Sanskrit mantra Om Namah Shivaya means with great respect and love I honor my heart, my inner teacher. With great respect and love I honor my heart, my inner teacher. How's that?